Hi there, I'm Sean Dooley and I'm the Product Marketing Manager at Arri. This is one of a series of Tech Talk videos to explain the features of the new Alexa 35. Come and join me over at our Lightbox where I'm going to be explaining all about the new electronic accessories for the camera and how to power it. The Alexa 35 is a 24-volt camera system with an operating range from 20 volts up to 34 volts. We made the decision to commit early to 24 volts with this camera because it's enabled us to create a smaller and more efficient camera package. We were also really hitting the limit of what was possible to achieve with existing onboard 12-volt battery systems when it came to image processing and accessory power output options. In order to have a 24-volt onboard battery system, we partnered with Bebob to create a new battery standard called B-mount. B-mount is open to the whole industry. It's not a proprietary battery mount. And so if you are a manufacturer of batteries or accessories, you can reach out to either Arri or Bebob and receive all of the specifications so that you can create your own product. We really want this to be the new industry standard. There are a whole heap of electrical and mechanical benefits to the B-mount system over existing systems, and I go into a lot of detail about that in the existing B-mount Tech Talk video, so go check that out on YouTube. In short, B-mount can provide up to 15 amps of current at 24 volts. That's more than three times the amount of power that most traditional 12-volt onboard battery systems were ever designed to provide. B-mount will be the standard battery mount for Arri lighting, camera, and stabilizer products moving forward. At the time of the camera's launch, we will see batteries readily available from Bebob, Core SWX, Swit, Anton Bauer, and Hawkwoods. And just about all other major battery manufacturers have already signed up to the B-mount program and will be producing batteries in the B-mount format. Another key feature of the B-mount system is that it's really small. It's only 8 millimeters thick, and it's just this U-shaped section on the back of the camera, which means you can also use B-mount for a lot of small accessories. On top of the extra power that the B-mount system can provide and the mechanical benefits, there's also a bunch of new ways that the batteries can communicate with devices such as the camera. So if I put two batteries onto the camera, like this, both of the percentage readouts for the remaining power in each battery can be shown on the side display of the camera. And just in case you were wondering, even though the camera runs at 24 volts and these are 24 volt batteries, there are still a range of 12 volt accessory power outputs on the camera. There are also a bunch of other ways that you can power an Alexa 35 with onboard batteries. One option might be to use the RAB2, that's the rear accessory bracket, and that will allow you to mount a B-mount adapter plate or the B-mount power splitting box further behind the camera. For instance, maybe you want to counterweight a heavy lens setup when you're using the camera on your shoulder. If you don't have a battery plate on the RAB2, there are also the mounting holes for the MDR3 and MDR4 and a whole bunch of other accessories which you can then have sitting behind a B-mount battery. Or if you have an existing onboard battery system for an Alexa LF, then we've come out with the BAB LF. This is the battery adapter back that turns the Alexa 35 into the same mounting points as an Alexa LF. That way you can use your existing power systems by just screwing these two plates together. However, we recommend that you don't use any plate that has a voltage booster in it, as that can generate extra heat. For the first time, with the Alexa 35, we're introducing a range of electronic accessories which become integral with the camera's form factor. The first one of these is the PDM-1, that's the Power Distribution Module. It has seven extra power accessory outputs. So we have four 3-pin RS connectors running at 24 volts that can supply up to 100 watts of accessory power. We then have two 2-pin LiMo connectors, and under here there's a twist DTAP connector, which is a DTAP connector where you can put the plug in both ways. Together, they will provide an extra 50 watts of power at 12 volts. As well, if you are running the camera from the power connector, these power accessory outputs will still be active even if you don't have a B-mount battery on the back. One key benefit of this is that if you are a user of the Arri ECS system and are used to running a lot of L-bus accessories such as C-force motors, you should no longer have to use an L-bus to DTAP cable for extra power, as the camera can now provide more than enough, especially with B-mount batteries. The second electronic module that we're offering for Alexa 35 is the AEM-1. That's the Audio Extension Module, and it marks the first time since Amira that we've had two channels of high-quality microphone preamps built into the camera. So on the side of the module, we have two mini XLR connectors, which will accept either a mic level or line level signal. And then inside the box, you can choose to activate phantom power, a high pass filter, a limiter, or phase reversal. Underneath that, we have another mini XLR connector, which will accept two channels of digital audio via an AES connection. Under that, there is a 24 volt 3-pin RS connector and a 2-pin LiMo connector offering 12 volt accessory power. At the bottom of the unit, there's a headphone output, and you can also use the headphone output that's already built into the MVF2, as that's one nice feature of this module in that you don't require any extra cables to get the audio data from the module into the camera. That all happens through the rear connector on the back of the camera. And then behind the audio module, you can put the same B-mount adapter or whatever onboard power solution you'd like to mount. On the other side of the module, we have a whole number of depressible rotary encoders, which you can use to set menu settings. And there are two dedicated encoders at the bottom, which you can use for the microphone gain if you are putting microphones into this unit. I cannot stress enough how impressive the audio quality is inside the AEM-1. It's made for us by Sonosax, who are a high-end Swiss manufacturer of audio equipment, and we really believe that this is now the best-sounding microphone preamp of any camera on the market. Because it has those two power accessory outputs as well, bringing the total in the camera to four, personally, I really think this is the module that most people will opt for, as you can pretty well leave it bolted to the camera the whole time and make this a really versatile package. Another new product that we're introducing alongside the Alexa 35 is the Arri Camera Companion app. The app is available for iPhones, iPads, and M1 Macs and gives me full control over the Alexa 35, as well as existing Alexa Mini, Alexa Mini LF, and Amira cameras. The interface is fully customizable. We will offer a bunch of presets, but you're also welcome to go in and make an interface which exactly suits your needs on set. I can go through the app and rapidly change exposure settings such as the ND value, or I can have really granular control over things like white balance. As well as full camera control and access to the web interface for the camera, I can do a bunch of new functions. So for example, while I can set the app to control the camera user buttons, I can also set up an infinite amount of local user buttons, which are specific to the app and give me access to new features which we haven't previously had as user buttons. I know that there will be a whole heap of ACs who are really happy to hear that we now have a sensor flip user button available through the app. We can also send frame grabs from the camera straight to the app so that you can share them with people or post them directly to Instagram. You can control multiple cameras from the app at the same time. For instance, I could have an A, B, and C camera selectable through buttons, or in this case, I have the A camera controllable in portrait orientation, and then in landscape orientation, I automatically switch to the B camera. You can do this with having multiple cameras on the same Wi-Fi network, or I can get the app to automatically change Wi-Fi networks between different cameras on set. The goal is for this app not to just be a replacement for the web interface, but instead we're working towards not having to have a USB stick inside the Alexa 35. We want to be able to make custom frame lines and send them from the app to the camera, or to share user setups between different cameras all through Wi-Fi. As an extra feature, we've also extended the app to the Apple Watch. So through the Apple Watch, I can go in and I can actually have full control over a whole bunch of different camera settings. I know this might sound like a bit of fun at the moment, but I'm sure someone's going to come up with a really cool use case for the Apple Watch app. All right, thanks for watching through to the end of the tech talk about electronic accessories for the Alexa 35. We'll see you in the next one.